Hi, my dear students. All of you, welcome to my class. Yesterday, we studied about some points in metallurgy. The first point is what is the first point? Minerals. What are minerals? The chemical substances which are obtained by mining from the earth crust are called as minerals, right? What are ores? The minerals which are chosen for the extraction of metals easily are called as ores. And we studied that all the ores are minerals, but all the minerals are not going to be the ores, right? If you take any ore, that ore contains some impurity. So to extract the metal from the ore, we have to remove impurity. That impurity present in the ore is called as gang. So now we can define the gang. What is gang? The impurity present along with the ore is called as gang. And next, the topic is metallurgy. The definition is the process of extraction of metal from the ores by using chemical methods is called as metallurgy. All this was discussed in the previous video. And in the previous video, we discussed one more thing, that is a concentration of ore, also called as dressing of ore, also called as beneficiation of ore. What is meant by concentration of ore? The process of removal of gang particles by using either physical methods or by using chemical methods is called as concentration of ore, also called as beneficiation or dressing. And there are different methods in concentration of ore. The first method we studied is hydraulic washing method. The second method studied is, what is the second method? Magnetic separation method. This was studied in the previous video. Now we are going to study another two methods, that is concentration of ore or ore concentration methods. Another two methods now we are going to discuss. The third method is froth flotation method. And the next method is leaching process, right? So today we are going to discuss two more ore concentration methods. The first one is froth flotation method and the next one is a leaching process, right? Just a minute, my dear students, I will share the screen and I will explain to you all those methods. Just a minute, wait please. Okay, my dear students, already in the last video we discussed about magnetic separation method. This is also one of the ore concentration method, right? Coming to the next method, ore concentration method, today we are going to discuss about this method. What is the method? Froth. I'm going to underline this one. Just a minute, wait please. Just a minute, please wait. Okay, right. So today we are going to discuss about this one, froth flotation method. Froth means nothing but foam. Foam. See here. This total part. See here. This total part is a froth. When we use froth flotation method, for which type of ores we use froth flotation method? For sulfide ores only, we are going to use froth flotation method. And what is the use of froth flotation method means? For the removal of gang particles from sulfide ores. Remember the word, froth flotation method is used for the removal of gang particles from sulfide ores. Okay, see here, what is the process involved here? First of all, we are taking a pulp of ore, that is the pulp, you know, pulp. That means ores are taken in the form of pulp, that is just crushed. Actually, the ores are present in the earth crust in the form of lumps. That lumps are crushed, then the obtained one are called as pulp of ore. So here, this is the pulp of ore. So that pulp of ore is mixed with suitable oils and that is taken through this inlet, right? So what is taken? Pulp of ore mixed with suitable oils is taken with the help of inlet, right? Okay. Then to that oil, some amount of what? To this oil and the pulp of ore, some amount of what is added? Water is added. Why water is added? Because to make a suspension, of a powdered ore is made with the water, right? That is the suspension form of ore, oil and water is taken into the rectangular tank. And in the middle of the rectangular tank, see here, in the middle of the rectangular tank, they're taking one stirrer. This is the stirrer. See this one. This is the stirrer. So with the help of this one, arrow mark, see here, this is the arrow mark, rotating paddle, we can easily stir that suspension. And at the top, you can see inlet for air. So when air is entering into the suspension, when air is drawn into the suspension, when stirring of suspension is happening, what will happen? Some bubbles will come upwards the beaker or upwards the tank. That bubbles, when they're collected with each other, then the obtained one is called as froth. Right, okay. What we are taking here, see here, we are taking a pulp of ore. So that pulp of ore is containing ore particles. And that ore particles, along with oil is lightweight. Oil is the lightweight. So that ore particles or the pulp of ore particles adhere to the oil and they come upwards. Where they are coming? The ore particles, pulp of ore particles are coming into the froth. Okay. At the bottom of the rectangular tank, what will retain? Gangue particles will retain. See here, at the bottom, at this one, at the bottom of the tank, here we can see what will retain these particles. What are the particles? What will retain at the bottom of the tank? Gangue particles will retain towards the or into the froth. What will come along with oil? Along with oil, which particles will come? Ore particles will come. By using this method, ore particles are wetted by oil. Once again, ore particles are wetted by oil. And see here, gangue particles are wetted by, this is a main important word, gangue particles are wetted by water. So with the help of formation of froth, the ore particles are collected into the froth and the gangue particles are going to settle down at the bottom of the beaker. This is the method called as froth flotation method. Observe here, in this froth flotation method, collectors and froth stabilizing agents are added. Collectors, what is the use of collectors? That collectors collects ore particles. Once again, the collectors collect ore particles from the suspension. What are the examples of collectors? Pine oils, fatty acids, and xanthates, etc. are acting as collectors. Of course, when we are going to stir the suspension continuously and air is drawn into the suspension, the bubbles are coming towards the surface and the bubbles are going to form the froth. But if we stand that froth, if we allow the froth to stand, after some time, the froth will go into the suspension. Once again, when the froth is allowed, the topmost surface froth is allowed to stand, after some time, the froth is going to enter into the suspension. Again, the ore particles enter into the suspension. That's why we have to avoid the entry of the froth again into the suspension. That means we have to stabilize the froth. So to stabilize the froth, what is added? Stabilizers are added. See here, froth stabilizers are added, like chrysols and aniline. Important one, froth stabilizers. Crisol and aniline are added to the suspension of ore, oil and water. When we are adding the stabilizers, froth stabilizers like crisol and aniline, then the total ore is going to be settled at the top. Then at the top in the froth, what will retain? Ore particles will retain. If we can remove that ore separately, and if the ore is subjected to dried up, then the oils get evaporate easily. So finally, we can get concentrated ore particles. That means the gangue particles are removed. So what is meant by concentration of ore? The process of removal of gangue particles or removal of impurities from the ore is called as ore concentration. When we are using froth flotation method, for which type of ores we use froth flotation method? For sulfide ores only, we are going to use froth flotation method. Okay, right. See here, one more concept is given here. See this one. Sometimes it is possible to separate, very important, sometimes it is possible to separate sulfide ores. It is possible to separate two sulfide ores. Once again, it is possible to separate two sulfide ores. Here we can see one sulfide ore is ZnS. ZnS is called as zinc blend. Remember, ZnS is called as zinc blend. And second one is PbS, lead sulfide. PbS, lead sulfide, called as galena. Spelling G-A-L-E-N-A. Remember the word? PbS is called as galena. So what are mixed together? ZnS called as zinc blend. This one, ZnS called as zinc blend. And PbS called as galena. Both are the sulfide ores of zinc and lead. When they are mixed with each other, to separate the zinc sulfide from PbS, to the mixer of zinc sulfide and PbS suspension, we are going to add depressant. Depressant. What is the depressant here? What is the depressant here? This is the one. Just a minute. So what is depressant? Which chemical is used as depressant? Sodium, NaCN, sodium cyanide is used as depressant. To the suspension of ZnS and PbS, when NaCN is added, only ZnS reacts with NaCN. And ZnS is entering into the suspension and PbS goes to froth. Once again, ZnS comes into the suspension by reacting with NaCN. It forms a complex, right? And PbS goes towards the froth. By removing the froth, we can separate PbS. So to separate the two sulfide ores when they're mixed with each other, then we are using what we use. Depressant. Here, for a mixture of ZnS and PbS, what is used as a depressant? NaCN, sodium cyanide. So, my dear students, this is the method. What is the name of the method? What is the name of the method? This is the method, froth flotation method. When we use froth flotation method, to concentrate the sulfide ores only. Okay. And it is important for a PU level, that is for a board level, maybe for 2 marks or 3 marks, whatever it may be, just you have to remember. Just a minute, my dear students. So this is all about a froth flotation method, which is used to concentrate the sulfide ores and which is also used to separate the mixture of sulfide ores. Okay, right. Coming to the next method. Just a minute. The next method, ore concentration method or concentration of ore. Another method studied is leaching. Leaching. Leaching means very simple. Washing again. But it is a different concept. Actually, in the first method, we studied hydraulic washing. That is a different one. Hydraulic washing is depending upon difference in gravities of war and gang. Once again, hydraulic washing method depends upon difference in gravities of war and gang. Coming to leaching, see here, leaching is often used if the ore is soluble in some suitable solvents. This is a word important. The ore is soluble, only the ore is soluble in suitable solvents, but not gang particles. Then only we use the method, leaching method, right? Suppose if you take bauxite, what is the formula of bauxite? In the first class, previous class, we studied the bauxite. Bauxite is an example of aluminium ore. Once again, bauxite is an example of aluminium ore. What is the formula of bauxite? The formula of bauxite is Al2O3. Al2O3, it is having some impurity. Here, suppose maybe silica is there as impurity. Or maybe Fe2O3, iron oxide, Fe2O3, iron oxide. This may be also as impurity. So bauxite is containing impurity, either it is Fe2O3. If Fe2O3 is there as impurity or as gang particle in the bauxite, that bauxite is called as red bauxite. If bauxite is having SiO2 as impurity, then the bauxite is called as white bauxite. So there are two types of bauxites. One is a red bauxite, second one is white bauxite. What is red bauxite? Al2O3 mixed with Fe2O3. What is white bauxite? Al2O3 mixed with SiO2 is called as white bauxite. Okay, just a minute. So our topic is about leaching process. When we use leaching process, tell me, when we use leaching process, when ore is soluble in suitable solvent, when ore is only soluble in suitable solvent but not in gang, then only we use leaching process. Example, leaching of alumina from bauxite. What is meant by alumina? In the first year also you studied, in the first PUC also you studied, what is alumina? Alumina is nothing but Al2O3. Alumina is nothing but Al2O3. See here, in this one, in this reaction, see this reaction. Here Al2O3. What that Al2O3 indicates? What that Al2O3 is indicating? The Al2O3 here. The Al2O3, nothing but we are taking bauxite, that is the ore of aluminium. Bauxite is an example of ore of aluminium metal. Okay, and here the bauxite suppose containing impurity. What is the impurity? The impurity is usually SiO2 and iron oxide, that is Fe2O3, and titanium oxide TiO2 acting as impurities. Then the bauxite, bauxite formula Al2O3 is leached with, that means washed with or dissolved in suitable solvent. Dissolving a ore is called as dissolution of a ore. Once again, dissolving a ore is called as dissolution of a ore. See here, dissolution of the powdered ore in what? Concentrated sodium hydroxide. This is a digested ore in concentrated sodium hydroxide solution. Then only the ore is going to be dissolved to form NaAlOH taken 4 times. Only ore is dissolved in suitable solvent. What is the suitable solvent here? Concentrated NaOH at 473 to 523 kelvins at a pressure of 35 to 36 bars pressure. Only ore is getting dissolved to form a complex. The complex is NaAlOH taken 4 times. Okay. What about the impurities? What are the impurities? See here, SiO2, TiO2, and iron oxides. They are the impurities. They are not going to get dissolved in the NaOH. Then the impurities or the gang particles are going to get settled down at the bottom. And by using filtration methods, we can separate the gang particles. Then we can get a solution. That solution is having dissolved form of ore. Then we have to extract that ore from the dissolved form of the ore. How we are going to extract? See here, how we are going to extract? So the dissolved form of ore, here it is alumina, or the bauxite is going to be in the form of dissolution form, that is in the form of NaAlOH taken four times. That is called as tetrahydroxo or hydroxy. Sorry, first Na is there. That is called as sodium. Sodium 4. Here 4 is there. That is tetrahydroxoaluminate 3. This is a complex compound. Complex compound. What is the complex compound formed here? Na square bracket of AlOH taken four times. My dear students, by yesterday itself, D and F block elements are started in another track of our chemistry syllabus. In that one, you can study about the complex compounds. There you can know about the IUPAC name of this complex. Just now I'm going to say only the name. Na is called as sodium, 4 is called as tetra, OH is called as hydroxy, Al is called as aluminium plus 8 aluminate 3. Right, I'm going to write the name. Just observe here, I'm going to write the name. So what is the IUPAC name of the complex Na Al OH taken four times? Na, that is sodium. Write down the IUPAC name of the complex. Sodium. Okay. 4 is there. That is called as tetra. OH is called as hydroxy or hydroxo. Sodium tetrahydroxo. Al is called as aluminate. Aluminate. Within brackets, Roman number 3. My dear students, this IUPAC names of complexes will be studied in the upcoming chapter, that is complex compounds. So wait until that to understand the IUPAC name of this complex. Okay. Na, Al, OH taken four times in the dissolution form, and the undissolved impurities are getting separated and precipitated. Then finally, we are going to treat the dissolved form of the ore, that is NaAlOH taken four times aqueous with carbon dioxide. We are getting Al2O3.xmols of H2O as a solid. Observe, solid, S is their solid. That means alumina having a hydration form, dot XH2O. H2O indicating hydrating form. So the hydrated form of alumina, I'm writing here, Al2O3 is called as alumina. If X moles of H2O is there, hydration, water is called as hydration, and it is in the form of solid, then we have to say it is as hydrated, write down, hydrated alumina. Al2O3 is called as alumina. Hydrated form of alumina is getting precipitated or settled down. If that Al2O3, last reaction, if that Al2O3.xmols of H2O is heated at a temperature of 1470 kelvins, then the total water of hydration is getting evaporated. Finally, we are going to have Al2O3. That is the pure alumina. That is the pure form of bauxite. All the impurities are removed and they are getting settled down. Right, in this process, in the process of concentration of bauxite, what is the leaching agent used? This will be the question asked. What is the leaching agent? Right, concentrated NaOH. See here. See here. What is used? A concentrated solution of NaOH at 473 to 523 kelvins and at a pressure of 35 to 36 bars pressure is used as a leaching agent. Once again, going back. So when we use leaching process, when the ore is only soluble in suitable solvent but not gang particles, right? This is about a leaching process. And some other examples for leaching process. This is main important in metallurgy of silver and that of gold. Very important in the metallurgy of silver and gold. What is the leaching agent? Diluted solution of NaCN or KCN. NaCN, sodium cyanide. KCN, that is potassium cyanide. Diluted solution of sodium cyanide or potassium cyanide is used as leaching agent. Leaching agent. Leaching agent in the extraction of silver and gold. See, suppose here, if you see M, M means metal. What is the metal here? Either it may be Ag or it may be Au. So how many moles of? 4 moles of metal. Here, which type of metal is considered? Not the pure metal. Here, which type of metal is considered? Impure metal. Impure metals contain which particles? Impure metals contain which particles? Right, very good. Impure particles, that is gang particles. So when impure gold or impure silver, Au or Ag, gold means Au, silver means Ag. Impure silver or impure gold when treated with cyanide solution, aqueous cyanide solution, either it may be sodium cyanide, see here, either it may be sodium cyanide solution or it may be potassium cyanide solution, in the presence of oxygen, the total metal, that is the silver or gold, is extracted into the solution as it's a cyanide complex. See here, this is a cyanide complex. 4 moles of MCN taken twice minus complexes in the form of solution. And impurity is going to be precipitated. And with the filtration process, impurity will be removed. And finally, in the solution, aqueous solution, what is there? Metal in the form of cyanide complex. This is the one. This is the one. See here. Metal in the form of cyanide complex. That metal in the form of cyanide complex, again treated with, into that solution of metal in the form of cyanide complex, which metal? Either it is silver metal cyanide solution or gold metal cyanide solution. What is added? Zinc solid, pure zinc is added. Then exchange of metal. In the first year or first PUC, you studied about a metal-metal exchange reaction. So here, M is going to be exchanged with Zn. Zn is going to be exchanged with M. So finally, we can get this one. Purest form of metal is going to be deposited. That means pure Ag or pure Au, pure silver or pure gold is going to be deposited. So in the extraction process of silver and gold, which one is used as a leaching agent? Aqueous cyanide solutions like sodium cyanide solution or potassium cyanide solution in the stream of air or in the stream of oxygen. See here, in the presence of or in the stream of air or oxygen is used, right? And these two reactions are important, my dear students. Remember all those reactions. To remember, you have to practice properly more number of times. Then only you can remember the chemical reactions. Otherwise, it is not easy. So try to practice every day, right? This is all about four concentration methods. How many methods are there? 4 methods are there. What is the first method? Hydraulic washing method. Second method is magnetic suppression method. Third method is froth flotation method. Remember, when we use froth flotation method, to concentrate the sulfide ores and to separate the mixture of sulfide ores, we use froth flotation method. And the last method is leaching method. And leaching method is the major important method that is used in the gold and silver industry. And the leaching agent for the gold and silver is sodium cyanide solution in the stream of air or oxygen. Okay. See here. Some in-text questions are given. 6.1. Read these two questions. Try to answer. I will send a PDF of this chapter. Try to answer these two questions. Right. And in the next video, we are going to discuss about extraction of crude metal from concentrated ore. Okay. My dear students, if you have any doubt, please watch the same video repeatedly. But one thing you have to remember, whenever you open my YouTube channel, whenever you are going to found some video lecture of my lessons, first you have to download from the YouTube. Then you are able to listen or watch to the same video any number of times, even without internet. So that's why I'm requesting you all, first try to download, then only watch those videos by putting your headsets. Right, after that, same thing every day. What I'm saying is same. That is, read the textbook and try to write down notes of yourself. Try to make answers of those in-text questions, what I'm going to provide as in the form of PDF. Right? Thank you, my dear students. Have a nice day.